Yangtze Life. I'm Wenji with Xinhua News Agency. Pottery has always been an important part of Chinese people's daily lives, as China is synonymous with porcelain. So here we are today in Jingdezhen, the famous city of porcelain in East China's Jiangxi province. We are going to discover the best pottery here and learn how to make a potter myself. And this is called Xujiadayao. It is a kiln that has more than 400 years old, which can be dated back to the Ming and Qing dynasty. So we are going to explore this place. And we have a pottery making master waiting here at the gate. His name is Yu Xilai. He is a very experienced pottery maker. Say hello to the audience. Okay, so let's follow him to discover how to make a pottery.
我们这个明清窑作群呢，是有一座柴窑，八间坯房组成的，从明末清初开始逐步完成的一个窑作群。
So you told us that this place was first built in the Ming Dynasty, and this place is actually the oldest one that's well preserved here in Jingdezhen. We can see, we can turn around and see that many craftsmen are working at their spot. And this is how porcelain or pottery is made. This is exactly the place. So you told me that to make a pottery or porcelain, we have to do it with our hands instead of machines. So it's a state-protected intangible cultural heritage. 那于师傅，我们如果要做一个陶器或瓷器，大概有多少道工序呢？
How many procedures are there? 陶器整个按照陶瓷它的工序是很多的。我们传统的说法是我们陶瓷是七十二道工序，但是从现在开始，我们这个地方它是从原料加工这部分不产生的，所以我们只要从拉坯开始，就是手工拉坯、立坯、挂坯，再逐步施釉，再到窑厂来烧，大概就是七八种工序。So
you told us that actually there are 72 steps in making pottery or porcelain. And here we are at the very first step. It's called throwing. I'm going to look for a master here to show me how to throw and do it myself.
你好。你好。这个，能不能先给我们演示一下吗？可以。这个拉坯。从流再来到，你把这个，你把这个。Okay,
so we see that a bowl is made. And guess what we are making now? It's going to be a bottle. It's amazing that we can see the bottle is gradually, well, it's finally made, the bottle. 我可以试一下吗? Can I have a try? 应该怎么做? Could you teach me how to... So I have to put my hands in the water first. And... Okay. Actually, you have to push so that this clay could gradually take shape. You need to push actually, need to push very hard. Okay, you have to push slowly. 那我现在在做的这个是个什么?
这个碗,
okay. So I'm going to make a ball.
我还需要再蘸点水吗?蘸点水。He
told me that it's easiest to make a ball.
这个是。OK。两个手。So I 慢慢慢慢的起来，上上带慢慢慢一点慢一点。
So I have to put my thumbs in the center of it.
好，可以。
Okay, so this one is a failure. So we can see how difficult it is to make pottery. I'm going to have another try, and hopefully this time I can succeed.
是怎么把它给拖走的？这样手就这样，那往上走就是。那就自己就出来了是吗？再试试。慢一点，手不要快了，你快了，手快了。但是我觉得下面走得很快。So
actually the key is to be as full as possible. Oh, okay, so this is a bowl, but it does not have a bottom. But this one is better than the first one.
那不舒服，您再做一个花瓶吧，换您来，我就不上手了。嗯，这次可以。你的手这样轻轻的往上走，越上来越慢，越上来越轻。
So, master told me to. We should put our hands like this and lift your thumb slowly.
Okay,
okay.
把它掐下来了，但为什么它还是没有底的？你把它，你没掐底下来了。
Okay, so this one looks better than the second one, but again, it's a bowl without a bottom. 师傅，您做一个花瓶吧，换一个花面。Now our master is going to make a vase. Okay, this one is very successful. This one is a bowl that I can. Enjoy my breakfast with. You 现在做的是花瓶。这是花瓶。 So this is mainly how we make pottery by scrolling, which is the very first step. And after scrolling, we are going to do something that's called painting. As we see, the many porcelain has patterns on them. So how are these patterns painted? We're going to invite this master to teach me how to paint. So as we can see, some patterns are already there. These patterns were painted by this master. But now he is filling these patterns. So when painting, you had to be very careful. I guess we are painting a flower here. Okay, so actually she has been painting this for about 40 years. She started paint when she was only 16 years old. And now I'm gonna have a try myself. 我能试着画一下吗?
可以。教一下吗?
I'm going to have a try. And hopefully this time I could be a good painter. Okay, so you have to hold this pen like this.
Okay,
so we have to lift this pen a little bit to with less strength. How do you think? Is it better? Okay, I'm gonna work hard at the next one. Okay, it looks better. Okay, so I'm going to give this back to our master. So this is actually how we draw patterns on a vase. It's a flower. Okay, 谢谢, thank you. So to make patterns on a vase, we not only have this way of painting, we also have another way that's called engraving. So here we are. We have another master. So as we can see, before engraving or carving, we need to paint the patterns with a pencil. Then we carve it like this. So just now we were painting flowers, and now this master is painting leaves, carving leaves.
city.
So I'm gonna try engraving on a smaller bottle. I'm gonna discover which one is easier, whether it's painting or engraving. Okay, I guess this is a flower too. So actually to engrave you need more strength than painting. Engraving is easier than painting. Okay. 那师傅大概这个如果要学的话，对于新手来说要花多久的时间呢？那新手上也有两三年。Okay, so the master told me that for a green hand, it takes about 2 to 3 years to learn on engraving. So it seems easy, but it's actually a difficult job. Thank you. Okay, so as we mentioned, there are altogether 72 steps in making pottery. So we are going to discover what are the other steps. Here we see we still have many craftsmen here. So here we also have some craftsmen working over there. Let's see what they are doing. Another master, let's ask what he is doing here. Okay, so this step is called 磨坯 or shaping in English. 那这一环节是为了要做什么吗? What's this for?
这个把坯表面把它打光，打光，我本身打光以后，再打已经打光了，打光了再把这个底把呢修一修。
So actually this step is mainly to make this bottom as smooth as possible. And in this step we need a knife. So we have to be really careful.
So this one is polished. So the bottom
is smooth and it looks better. And as we can see, there are some broken pieces over there.
So I've already
smoothed
it, so it's a big
difference. is here, which actually implies us that it's another very difficult step. Because if you're not careful, you will hurt your own finger or you will break these balls into pieces. So now, what I'm going to do? After the pottery goes all these procedures, we still have one last step to do, which is called glazing. But the master is upstairs, so let's go upstairs and look for him. So just now we see those pottery was still in the color, the same color as mud. So how are those pottery in the color of white or red as we see in our daily life? In the next step of glazing, we are going to discover that. The master here. He is the master of glazing. So this master is going to show us how to do glazing in a traditional way. This one is glazed. As we can see, our master actually blow air into this bottle and finish glazing. So actually this takes a lot of efforts. But actually, luckily we have another way, which is a modern way to put glaze on the bottle. 我们现在能演示一下用这个现代的方式怎么？可以吗？ 谢谢师傅. So as we can see with this machine, it's easier to finish this step of glazing. So let's go to the final step, which is called firing. because now the bottle, the vase is still not in the color of white or red. So how do we make it the color we want? How are they born and become the way we see them in our daily life? We're going this way. So now we have to go downstairs to look for the place where we fire these pottery. It's called fiery.
我来介绍一下，这是我们徐家窑。实际上呢，这徐家窑只不过是名称，实际上我们这个是柴窑，也叫正窑。从形上叫呢，它是一个鸭蛋一体窑。这个柴窑呢，是建于明末清初。而且这座窑在我们历史上有重要贡献，因为它在49年解放了以后啊，就成立了一个建国市场。 建国市场是我们请的政府第一早的市场，也是第一大市场。当时呢，遗留这个柴窑以后呢，就做这里有一个车间专门生产那个国家礼品瓷。我们陶瓷区有将近20%。So
this place is very special. It's called 徐家窑. It's special because it uses firewood as its burning material, and it has a history of more than 400 years. It's first built in the Ming Dynasty, and many souvenirs that's given to foreign friends are actually made by this place.
所以那个窑是在对这个窑呢，占地面积1000多平方。这个像这种屋角啊，它有108根。这种屋角，整个这个空荡的地方是堆放下货的。
So we can see there are some containers on our side. They are called 霞波. So when we go through the last step, which is firing, we need these containers to hold the pottery we make.
这些霞玻它们有什么作用吗？霞玻就是张胚的，我们陈胚以后就装在霞玻里堆放在窑里烧。这座窑你看到吧？那里有个标识，看一下。这座窑在79年的时候停烧了，停烧了呢，在12年的时候我们开始恢复按原样，基本上是我在这里按原样把它分批的。被摔碎吗？还是？这个霞玻。
对。
这个霞玻，不是因为我们这个柴窑它不能裸烧，因为胚互相不能堆放。
So as the bowls or bottles we made could not be put together, so we need this container to hold them. And
在下面.
Okay, so the kiln is right here. This is the 徐家柴窑. So this is, it looks like a cave, but it's a kiln that we fire those pottery we make. Let's go and see what it looks like inside. It's a little bit darker than the outside. Okay, so this place is as long as 17 meters and as tall as nearly 6 meters.
目前我们这种柴窑是景德镇最大柴窑，它的整个容量就是用那个窑弹计算，它在320担左右。
它跟一担是多少呢？一担就是这个虾波2米88以为一担，我们要满到320担，这种空间呢很大。
Okay,
so you told me that this place is actually the biggest one here in Jingdezhen. But I'm wondering actually, what temperature should we keep and how long does it take for firing?
师傅大概我们烧制的时候需要多少温度，还需要多少时间？这个我们烧成温度呢，都是像那个其他差不多1300多度。我们这种窑的温差很大，它相隔了到80度，低的它可能呢在1260度，高温可能在，大概多少时间？烧24个小时左右，但是这个时间不固定的，看我们烧什么品种。
So generally it takes about 24 hours for firing, and we need a temperature that's about 1300 Celsius degrees.
这满完以后，我们要把这个门口封起来，做一个头材口，下面是火仓。我们这是平面式窑，往后走的，火往后走。我们合理的利用这种空间来满这种下坡。
So these containers would be in the kiln we just saw. The potteries would be held inside them. But after firing, how would these pottery or porcelain look like? We're going to discover upstairs.
你看呢，现在我们走的楼叫柴楼。 这种楼梯啊，就是便于我们以前的人挑窑柴上楼，老使劲，它不是这种坎。These
steps are very special because they are made of the firewood. So this is how the kiln actually looks from outside. It's very long, as I mentioned, it's about 17 meters. And I'm saying one version goes that it actually looks like a dragon. So it has a name as Long Yao in Chinese.
So right over
there, these are firewoods. Our burning materials. So today we still use them as burning materials. That's exactly what our ancestors did in the Ming Dynasty. So another version is that this kiln looks like an egg or half an egg. Do you think so?
So
these bricks are called Yao Bang. We need these bricks to make this big cave. I can feel a history of more than 400 years old. are in different colors, red, blue, white. Which one is your favorite? So actually these could be used as decorations at our home, but as I mentioned, porcelain, pottery have been an important part in our daily life. So here I have found another, which is a cup. Chinese people like to drink tea by using these cups made of porcelain. So if you like tea and if you like porcelain, you can come here and drink tea with a cup that's made of porcelain. So let's sit down and enjoy the tea. That's pretty good. So this wraps up our third episode of Yangtze Life. I'm Wenji with Xinhua News Agency. We're now traveling along China's longest river, Yangtze River, and next stop would be Yangzhou in East China's Jiangsu Province. We're going to see how opera performers put on makeups in Yangzhou and enjoy Chinese traditional operas. If you're interested, please follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, and enjoy the culture, food, and scenery along the Yangtze River. See you next time. Bye.